everybody, and welcome to another episode of Elizabeth's Plays Subnautica with Science. Welcome back to the stream. It is Tuesday, which means it must be Subnautica time. As I mentioned previously, I am currently planning on doing Tuesday's Subnautica, Thursday's Depth, Friday's, Saturday's XCOM, with possibly some exceptions. This is all malleable, but today we're doing Subnautica. Before I get started, a couple of disclaimers first. I'm going to be talking about science and speculative fiction on this show. None of the views, opinions, or anything else expressed on this show belong to my employers. Those are mine and mine alone. This is my show. I take full responsibility for it. This is going to be As always, a science show in part. I'm going to be talking about science news stories from the week and old science stories as well. However, this is all going to be off the cuff. I have some note cards to help me get my facts straight, but there's always a chance that I might get something wrong. So fact check me before repeating all these to your friends. I'm going to put the stories that I talk about in the channel, as always, and when this goes up on YouTube, because I plan to put it up on YouTube, then you should be able to see the links in the description. But still, if you notice me saying something inaccurate or just flat out wrong, please tell me, and whether it's 5 minutes ago or 6 months ago, I will do everything I can to make a correction. and one more thing, because of some of the science stories I'm talking about this week, this is a science show, and in addition to talking about regular old G-rated science stories, I also plan on talking about flinging cough drops everywhere, apparently. I also plan on talking about some of the squishier sides of science. This includes sex, gore, violence, internal organs. And if that makes you uncomfortable or you don't want to hear it, this might not be the show for you. And I think that about does it. So, with that, let's play some Subnautica. Also, I am still finally kicking this cold. I did a lot of talking at work today, so I am gonna have cough drops. But I also have coffee. Cough drops first, then coffee. Alright, we got our spaceship loading here. Last time on Subnautica, we managed to build a sea glider. We crashed onto this alien planet that seems to be mostly covered in water, or at least our portion of it. And then we wound up building a sea glider, a couple of tools. We discovered some stalkers, which are kind of like a cross between alligators and ichthyosaurs, I think I described them as, and some manatee-looking things, which can kill you extremely rapidly if you get too close. So we won't be doing that. I have got some great science speculation about these animals, based on me being a little bit bored while waiting for the train last week. And here we are in our little escape pod. We fixed it last time, so there's no longer smoke pouring out of everything. Man, those manatees sound creepy. So we have a couple of priorities this time. Let's go over the communications relay really quick and remind ourselves. I don't want to poke this. I want to listen to it. How do they do that? It's gonna take me a moment to relearn all the controls. Alright, never mind the communications relay. We had two new messages basically saying, here's our coordinates, we need help, but you're gonna need a radiation suit and a laser cutter. So let's check, first of all, what it's gonna take to make that radiation suit, because I think that's gonna be our first priority this time. Radiation suit. Fiber mesh times 2 and lead times 2. And also we wanted to make a laser cutter. for which we need a diamond. We can make a battery, no problem, but the diamond's going to be a problem. All right, so we need mesh and diamond. That's going to be our goals for this hour. Hours. I plan on playing more than 1 hour. We're a little low on water, so, well, we don't have a bladderfish, so we're kind of stuck. How do we make mesh? I'm guessing we make mesh out of synthetic fibers, for which we need... Oh, no, wait, we need fiber mesh for that. How do we make fiber mesh? It's got to be in here somewhere. I must just be missing it. Deployables? We have a sea glide. Maybe fiber mesh is just one of those things you pick up. Plasteel ingot. Benzene, synthetic fibers. Blood oil times 3. Well, we need to find out where blood, what and where blood oil is in the first place. Alright, so, I have no idea where we'd find a diamond, but I'm sure we'll come across one sooner or later. Ah, look at that beautiful blue sky. Now, we are a little low on water. And, I'd like to grab some sustenance for us before we start out. What is that off there? Oh, that's a manatee. Nope. Not gonna get too close to you. Oh, that must be the coordinates for one of the escape pods. Let's grab some food before we set out. Come here, bladderfish. And get a peeper or two. Thank you! Because we may be out for a while, and we're going to want to eat something, presumably, at some point along there. If you are watching the stream and you have any goals for me during this episode, please feel free to put them in the chat. I'm always open to suggestion. And those things creep me out. So I did some reading on whale communications over the weekend. And not entirely because of this, but it was on my mind. Not going to lie about that. One of the things that struck me as I was... manatee, go away. One of the things that struck me... as I was doing this reading was that that was sort of the purpose of the particular tones that whales use as they do their whale song. One of the things about whale song that's really important is that a lot of the tones that they use are really low, and one of the reasons for that, partly because they're really big. Big things tend to make larger noises just statistically, but ooh. Break through that? No. But also, loud, low tones carry a lot farther in the water than high-pitched noises. So dolphins have high-pitched squeaks that they make.
Oxygen.
I'm going up. But whales can use their much lower songs to communicate over... hundreds of miles, because the sound just reverberates and carries incredibly well through the ocean. I'm not seeing any more bladderfish. Anyway, so I was thinking about the sounds those manatees are making. Those are pretty low tones, honestly. So I'm thinking, well, are those grunts just to communicate with each other, or do they have some sort of longer distance communication thing going, and we're wandering into the realm of the stalkers over here, so I'm gonna go back towards the pod. I wonder if there's some kind of gun I can craft. I'll check that when we go in and dispose of this bladderfish. There don't seem to be any more. Hope that's not gonna be a problem. I'm sure we'll find some more. Oh wait, that's a... medical fabricator kit. I see. Well, I hope it recharges. Otherwise, we may have a problem. Let's make some water. Filtered, please. Let's cook a peeper. Add another peeper. Add another peeper. And a boomerang. Now let's go into our inventory. Eat ourselves a peeper or two. Drink some water. You know, we probably don't need both of those first aid kits. Alright, so we can go to Life Pod 6 or Life Pod 17. Yeah, that's an echoing call. That is going to carry a long distance. Do I have any water in here? I do. Let's go ahead and drink that because we need it. Power is at 86%. Do we have any batteries in here? Because if we do, we're going to be able to go farther. No. Let's quick check and see what it takes to make batteries. That's going to be under, presumably, electronics. Acid mushroom times two. We have copper ore. Let's go grab some acid mushrooms. I'm really surprised I can't make the fibers. I really hope I figure out the fiber mesh, that is. I really hope we figure out where to find those. Alright, let's go out, grab some of those acid mushrooms. Make a battery for a sea glide so we don't get stranded out in the middle of frickin' nowhere. That was the only copper ore we had. Fortunately, we've got more. I drank my filtered water. Guess not. Two batteries. Excellent. And we're gonna have to figure, so we need, other things we need are blood oil, so we can make benzene, and we're gonna need some synthetic fibers. And I hope that does it. All right, let's go exploring. Where shall we head out to? All right, so we got two life pods. One more towards the Aurora than the other. Let's go towards the farther away one. Carefully circumventing these manatees. Man, I'm surprised these things don't give off blood oil, whatever that is. There's some more metal salvage. That looks like another stalker habitat over there to me. Man, there's tons of salvage over here. What's in here? Apparently nothing. Let's go get some air. about you, this looks like stalker habitat. This is deeper water to me. Also, that's action music. Let's save our battery here. I don't see any, though. So we may be good. Ooh, that's getting deep. I see bladderfish. Let's go up and get some air and then come down for some bladderfish. Also, the sun's setting. That's a good sign. Because being in deep water when it's dark out is a really great idea, right? Radiation detected. Oh, there's a stalker. Shoot. Oh, I remember the fish I was trying to think of the name of last time. I was trying to think of a stickleback fish. The males make some nests out of things like, where'd the stalker go? Ha ha, tunnel. Ooh, what was that? Also, where did the bladderfish go? I want one. There's one. Come here, fish. You look delicious. Yeah, we are getting pretty close to the Aurora. Let's maybe back off a little bit. We're actually getting pretty low on health, all things considered. Radiation is bad for you. We're off in some alien sea. We don't want to get cancer. We just want to find diamonds. And run into walls. Ah! Run away! That would not have helped with the whole health thing. Why didn't I pick you up? Inventory full. Well, that'll do it. Let's go drop off some of that junk we picked up. Ah! And not run into the manatee. No sign of diamonds. I think they're a little bit farther away. Alright. Do you have anything in you? Yes, but not that much. Let's drop off some more quartz. Pick up some copper ore. This can be our quartz locker. You know what? We don't really need the creep vine cluster, I don't think. We can just drop that. We got lots of it. Let's head back up in here, because night's fallen, and we're not so good on the health. You know what? We have first aid kits. What am I talking about? And there's another one! How handy. Hey, greens, kitties. Nice to see you in the chat. Let's make some water here. The sun is setting. That's actually, I was gonna be sarcastic about it, but I'm inside, so that's actually good information. I don't know why I'm wasting all my energy making food I don't need. Hey! I can cure a boomerang. Do I want to waste one of my salt deposits on it? Yeah, I do. That'll be handy for a longer journey. Okay. Let's go ahead and drink some water. We can throw away. Oh, we don't want to eat those. Eat them. Those. Let's go outside again. It's so pretty out at night. And we can dump some of these old cooked peepers. Or eat them! That's not what I wanted to do. At least I didn't eat the decomposing one. We can dump the acid mushroom, too. Frankly, all this ore, too. The crash fish powder we can keep. Let's go inside and reduce some of that metal debris we found down. Basic materials, titanium. How are we for power? We're fine. It'll be morning soon enough. I have so much titanium. I'm gonna make a titanium ingot. All I need is silicone rubber. Hey, wait a minute. I can make that, or I could if I hadn't just dumped my creep vine plants. I was just thinking that advanced. I need to find fiber mesh. I may actually wind up taking a break to look that up at some point, because if I just wander around looking for it, that's going to be really boring for everybody. First aid kit, fire extinguisher, thermometer. Alright, well, let's check that inventory again. Are we carrying around a lot of unnecessary stuff? Yes. You know what? Let's go ahead and make another waterproof locker, and we'll just use it to store all of our titanium. Alright. See you right on down here. There we go. Edit locker label. There we go. Titanium. Ta-da! And let's just go ahead and stick the crash fish powder in there, too. And a first aid kit, because why not? Hopefully the sun will be rising soon. I didn't want to pick it up, I wanted to scan it. Oh, I can scan that. That's handy. What can you tell me about this blue palm? Alien life forms. Encyclopedia entry unlocked. That's great. Again, it's not gonna get me any synthetic fibers, though, is it? I swear these things must give you blood oil if you know what you're doing. Like, they look like they should give off something called blood oil, don't they? Thought about whale communications in the manatees while I was researching whale communication the other day. One of the cool things about bladderfish is that you can eat them. Thank you. That'll be helpful with the water situation, which unfortunately was. What is that? Is there a stalker right on top of me? There was! He was chomping on me! Or maybe just following me, I don't know. Can you scan the stalker? Yes, do it. Ah, nope, he's mad at me now. I just want to learn about you! And not have you eat me! I want the encyclopedia entry. Is that so wrong? Yes. Probably is. Not good for one's health in an alien ocean. Oh yeah, whale communications. So, turns out that there are two main kinds of whales on Earth's oceans. There's the toothed whales and the baleen whales. And they create sound in radically different ways. Let's make some water. The baleen whales, so like your humpback whales, your bowhead whales, your right whales, they make sound by, well, see, that's the thing. Nobody's entirely sure exactly how they make sound. We're pretty sure that that has something to do with vibrating air in their larynx. Kind of like how we do it, but, scientists aren't entirely sure. There's a lot of theories out there, and, none of them have been entirely proven one way or the other. Yeah, get hydrated. What are those things? Oh, those are batteries. Good, we'll need those. Alright, we're at 100% health, and we've got a first aid kit. Let's go a little bit farther afield. I think we'll go past the kelp habitat and see what lies beyond that. Apparently more kelp habitat. And some deeper water. That's cool. So yeah, nobody quite knows how the baleen whales do it. But, ooh, look at that! That looks like something that could potentially kill us. That's hot water. Yep, case in point. I knew it. Whoa! That's a volcanic vent right down there. Did it go away, or is it still there? Oh, yep. Let's not go down there, maybe. Cool, though. I wonder if we'll be able to put that to good use. Didn't the sun just come up? Like, a little while ago? Oh! Oh, cool! It's an eclipse! Look at that! Oh, that's beautiful. That's a wonderful thing about a planet with two moons. Twice the eclipses. Also, that's a really cool game mechanic. Alright, yes, I hear you, whales. Manatees. Oh, there's a salt deposit. Let's grab that. What is that rumbling? Probably nothing good. How close are we to the Aurora? Let's not get too much closer to it. Check orientation. Yeah, I could have sworn we were going away from it in comparison to the... Oh well. Going beyond the kelp habitat was our goal for today, and that's what we are doing. Let's not go down there. There's a stalker down there. There's probably gonna be a crash fish down here somewhere. Or not. You know. Instead, there's gonna be a manatee apparently right on top of us. You know what? Let's brave the stalkers and go down there and see if we can see anything. Ooh, that looks like a different kind of stalker. Looks like it's covered in glowy things. Some kind of camouflage. Ooh, look at that. Those look like they hurt. Yep, those hurt. Those actually hurt a lot, actually. Let's not touch them again. There's a whole ton of them! Ah! Let's try to head up out of here. 30 seconds. Let's use a... Alright, yep, we are stuck underwater here. We might well die down here, because I got lost.
Oxygen.
I'm swimming up! I'm trying! I think I'm blacking out down here. I think that's what this is meant to represent. Either that or the game is glitching like crazy. I think it's the latter. Oh, that's a little embarrassing. Lesson learned, those things hurt. Don't touch them. I don't think we had anything too valuable in our inventory, though. What did we lose? Yeah, we lost a crash fish. Hey, we kept our cooked boomerang, though. So, no harm done. Let's just go ahead and pick up another first aid kit and not touch those things again. I'm gonna have to pick up some more boomerangs, though. Sorry, bladderfishes. I keep calling them boomerangs. Boomerangs are something entirely different. Alright, so we know what lies beyond the kelp forest in the direction of the aurora. What about in a different direction? Like, what happens if we go off this way? Let's see what happens if we go off this way. We see some quartz. We don't need any quartz. That's good to know. If you see something that looks like diamond, please do speak up. What is that? Creature egg. I wonder if it's a stalker egg. Ah, there's some bladderfish. Come here, you. And that's a stalker.
30 seconds.
All right, we'll go up. There we go. Ooh, new kinds of fish. I don't think you can pick those up, though. That looks like the same kind of habitat where we died before. Plus, I don't think I honestly have that much oxygen on me. What is that? That looks like something I don't want to touch. Well, maybe it is. I don't know. This looks like red stuff. That means... First of all, I haven't seen it before. Second of all, maybe this is the source of that blood oil stuff we were talking about. These are whole new kinds of fish. Oh, look at that. That's an armored kind of fish. I like the looks of that. Also, this glowy blue stone. Grassy biome supports biodiversity both above and below the surface. Cool. Let's get up here then. Well, not really anything visible from the surface. I mean, I believe it. But, where'd it go? There's a stalker. Let's not tangle with it. See, that stalker doesn't have those green dots on it we saw before. Thanks, beeper. So yeah, what's that? That's a salt deposit. Lots of salt deposits around here. That's great. I'm gonna keep following this field of red grass, since it seems to be the biome beyond the kelp, so to speak. Maybe there are things here, some resources that we haven't found out about yet. Like that. Like, what is that? I don't know. Ah! What hit me? Oh, that thing. Okay, lesson learned. I was right. They hurt you. Whee! Leaping up out of the water and back down. Definitely a good policy. Okay, lesson learned. Don't stay too close to the ground here, because things hide in it. On the other hand, there's limestone ore in that stuff. What is that noise? What are you? Spadefish. Call a spadefish? Sorry, that's bad. Alrighty. Alright, so those red guys. What is that? What is that?
30 seconds.
That looks dangerous, but also really cool. That looks big. Let's eat something, I guess. Creature egg. Oh, those take up a lot of space. Do we have any cooked... We have an old cooked peeper. That'll do. Where did that... What is that? It's like a giant... There's tons of them! Whoa. It's turning towards me. I don't want to hurt you. It's like a whale, but also a squid. Definitely squid-like elements there. Namely, the tendrils. Are you turning towards me or away from me? I can't tell what you're doing. I'm gonna steer away from these things because they could definitely eat me if they wanted to. Oh, there's the one of the escape pods. Well, there's whales between me and it. I call it whales. I really more like squids. Let's, you know what? Let's see if we, how far we can make it towards this thing. Oh, I see glowy things. Generally, that's a bad thing in this game. Whoa, they glow on the underside. What is all this? Looks like a debris field. We won't get too close to that. We'll just go right around it. Also, I really hope that the battery, in retrospect, can be used to power the sea glide. So that's an O2 tank. Sea glide. Because otherwise we're going to be stuck out here for a while. Alright, well now we know we can get out here again. If we're just careful about the, pretty much everything, really. So I'm going to head on back. Grab some fish for dinner on the way. And some of these delicious bladderfish. Or water. There has to be another way to make water in this game. Instead of just relying on endless bladderfish. I got the feeling there's something around here. You ever get that feeling? Like, there's definitely something around here, I'm just missing it. I don't want acid mushrooms, but you know what? I'll take it anyway. Man, these forests are pretty at night. A lot of green stuff in them. If it were on Earth, I'd say that's a lot of stuff photosynthesizing, but what do I know? This is an alien planet. Maybe it means something entirely different. Get back here. Maybe we'll get synthetic fibers if we rescue the first set of folks. There's the manatees. I haven't seen them anywhere else. There's lots of habitats with stalkers in them, but not so many of the manatees. You know, we picked up plenty of salt deposits on that last run. I can see the sun is setting. Though those eclipses were pretty cool. Still can't pick up any of those things. Don't even know what they are. Actually, you know what? We have a scanner. Scan one. A rabbit ray.
Oxygen.
Or let's breathe. That's good too. Alright, so we know what it's called, but we don't know anything about it. Maybe if we scan it, we'll be able to unlock something. Alien life forms, rabbit ray. You know there's an invertebrate on Earth called a sea hare? I honestly didn't make the connection until now, but they are kind of similar. Sea hares, I believe, are nudibranchs, which resemble the rabbit rays on this planet a fair bit. Let's make some water. Because you go through water fast in this environment. Really easy to get dehydrated while you're swimming slash diving. You can change the Seek-A-Life battery, press R, and choose a new one. Great to know! I will definitely do that on our next expedition out. What? Ooh, I can cook a spadefish. Blah. But let's cook the peeper. Then cook the spadefish. And we can cure some peepers. And we don't want to cook the bladderfish, we want to reduce it into delicious clean water. Alright. We're good. Let's consume some of this. I'll take it in a minute. Probably another pod.
This is Avery Quinn of Trading Ship Sunbeam. Aurora, do you read? Over. Still nothing. These old Terra ships, they run out of engine grease. They send an SOS. Offer to help. They don't pick up. Aurora, I'm out on the far side of the system. It's going to take more than a week to reach your position. Do you still need
yes.
our assistance?
Yes, we do. We do definitely still need your assistance, thanks.
I'll try them again tomorrow. See what the long-range scan picks up in the meantime? Damn charter's gonna have us wasting our profit margin running errands for Altera.
Well, for what it's worth, I appreciate it. Okay. So we're fine for food. What did we literally just make? Let me refresh my memory here. We got some salt deposits, random metal salvage. Let's reduce that metal salvage. Down to titanium. Oh, I forgot. We have enough salt for magnesium. Let's make that before we waste all of our salt on cured fish. Fortunately, now we know where to get more. And make a battery, because we have the stuff on hand, and why not? Alright. Ah, we got a new first aid kit. Grand. Okay, you know? An old cooked spadefish. Let's eat it before it goes bad. You know what? I think we're good to go. Let's head out. We wanted to head towards the one which is not towards the Aurora. The Aurora is there. So yeah, let's head out to this ship. See what we can see. If we set out now, we'll be there by sunrise. We'll stick near the surface, try not to run into any whales. Just go skipping along the surface like a dolphin. And avoid that debris field. There it is. Let's go around it. It's always easy to forget how deep you are, too. That's another thing you have to watch out for in real diving. Always watch your depth. That's quite far down. In fact, at this point, I think it's a mostly vertical depth. I hope the pressure isn't going to be a problem. Because from what I hear, it is a mechanic in this game. Nope. Frankly, 100 meters down would be a problem in real life, but... Ah! Get away, you. Ooh. Oh, cool biomes. Life pod 17. Oh. This looks like dead. Abandoned PDA.
Integrating new PDA data. 30 seconds.
Let's get up there. We'll check the PDA once we get, once we make sure we're not right on top of any whales. You know, let's check this wreckage. Maybe there's some, material we can scavenge down here. That stuff's sparking. Don't want to get too close to that. And that stuff looks like it's glowing. So that probably means radioactive. What's that? That's a salt deposit. We're gonna have to make a bunch of dives up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down. Watching our power to make sure we don't die while we're on the ocean floor. Let's cut that spadefish or not. Copper ore, that's grand. That stuff's sparking. Ah, nope. Don't want you. A biter. How appropriate. I wanted to scan that thing.
30 seconds.
I need more air tanks. I guess you can swap the. You can probably swap those out too. Yeah, okay, that's a good idea. I'll make one next time I'm, back at the pod. Swapping out air tanks while you're underwater is actually a fairly advanced move. Or at least it is if you're trying to, if you have different combinations of air in each tank. Which is absolutely a thing. I think I could scan in here. You don't want to start breathing the wrong kind of air when you're at depth. That's a good way to die. You know, this is still giving me a beacon. Let's get up to the surface and then read that datapad. Oh, it switched out the,
oxygen.
Oh, yes, I know, I'm almost there. Power, 9%. Alright, let's swap that out. Okay, where's the datapad? Log, voice log. Databank. Data downloads, life pods, anonymous crew log. Life pod made planetfall impact approximately 1 hour ago. Environmental instructions for instruments were knocked offline. The hole is beginning to buckle. I can see what's left of the Aurora from the top hatch. We were carrying anything and everything we might need to complete the phase gate. Mobile vehicle bays, bioreactors, propulsion cannons. I'm going to go out there and scavenge what I can with my hand, see if I can reinforce the life pod hull. Well, given the giant hole we saw on the side of the life pod, it didn't get very far. Anything to scan here? Searching.
30 seconds.
There we go. I'd like to think that one of those whales bashed into the side of the pod. See, that data pad makes me think there's something in here worth salvaging, but I don't want to get too close to the electricity. Oh. Somebody had a girlfriend or a wife or a daughter back home. That's sad. You know, for all that seems to indicate that there was something worth salvaging here, I'm not really seeing anything.
30 seconds.
Certainly no diamonds or synthetic fibers, which is what we're looking for. The debris are a massive glitch. There must be one massive wreck. Well, I see a communications thing off to the right. Looks like we've got a new call. Let's head back to the pod, see if we can make some more air tanks. I got completely distracted from talking about whale communications, didn't I? Anyway, so in looking at how the manatee things might communicate, I promise I'll learn the name for them one of these times. I was reminded of how toothed whales, specifically sperm whales, communicate. They make their signature clicking noises by forcing air through a set of valves. Oh, cool! There's a light on this thing. Inside of the air passages in their lungs, and these things are called monkey lips. I'll get more about monkey lips in a minute.
We just picked up a massive debris field at your location.
Gee, you think?
I didn't know how bad. How many of?
You bet. You're sorry. You were so sarcastic now, aren't you?
We're now en route.
You
to your
feel
location.
Bad.
We're gonna bring you home. Sunbeam out. Landing in the Academy simulator holds a bad situation, but so are all the alternatives.
You know what? You might want to figure out how to turn off your comm system, because that's kind of rude. Not so good for the morale. Oh, shut up, manatees. Let's make some more resources. Did I pick up any bladderfish on the way there? I think I did. I did. Nothing else, but that's alright. We're not that hungry. Alright, air tanks. What do I need for those? Glass! I have that! That's no problem. Let's see. Let's get some more filtered water in here, and I made a whole ton of it earlier, so let's make another oxygen tank. Well, actually, first let's drink some water, because we're thirsty, and that'll free up some space in our inventory. Don't eat the cured fish. We'll just grab some fish and cook it in a minute. There's another O2 tank. And another O2 tank. Alright, how much is this taking in our inventory? They're pretty big. Let's dump these creature eggs. I'm sure they'll come in handy for something, because they look pretty cool. But, not right now. And we'll dump this glass, too, because we don't need it. If you watch me play these kinds of games for any length of time, you'll realize that I hoard everything. I'm not good with leaving stuff behind. Alright, we still don't have any of the things we set out to get at the beginning of this game. Might want to save and reload, maybe. How many hours have I logged? I think I played, 2 hours last time I streamed? Not that long. Hence why I'm still pretty much a novice at this. But yes, I will, I'm gonna go ahead and save this. Let's see. What is that? Oh, that's all the titanium I dumped here last time. Along with a rotten cooked boomerang. That's not gonna decompose! Okay. Okay. So where am I gonna find any of those two that I was looking at last time? Not that I was looking at last time. Excuse me. That I'm looking for in the first place. Oh, I didn't notice they have little fins up near their face. Like little, steering fins, I guess. Oh, wow, that drastically increased how much oxygen I have available at my disposal. That is super handy. The sun's going down. You know what? That never stopped me from exploring. I don't want to go too close to the aurora because radiation poisoning is a thing. And we got it bad last time we tried exploring out that way. So, oh, nope. Not right on top of the mantis. Nope, nope, nope. Let me check. We don't really have that much food. We've got a lot of filtered water. I'm gonna grab a few more random fish, cook them, and then we can head out again. What is that? Oh, limestone. What was that? Oh, that's lead. I wonder if diamonds can be contained in limestone here. They wouldn't be in real life, but you know what? I'm pretty sure lead wouldn't be either. Oh, nope, that's a stalker. Nope. I'm leaving you alone, you can leave me alone. I don't wanna mess with you. I don't really know what I'm looking for. I'm not gonna find any diamonds around here, I can tell you that. Just want some fish for dinner. Stop swimming. Thank you. And you can't eat the rays. Apparently. What is that noise? Oh, that's that cloud of stuff which you don't want to mess with. It'll kill you. I think I've eaten most of the fish out from around my area. Like humans do. I assume they would respawn. Again, the critical mistake of most fisheries. Never just assume that your fish will respawn. Oh, there was some happy news about a certain species of rockfish, though, just out today. Turns out that by careful management of its fisheries, I hear the eggs hatching. That's bad. Turns out that they've managed to replenish the fisheries of this rockfish. And my inventory's full. So So those are now open for fishing again. The comment about saving and reloading was meant for you when you were at that wreck. Yeah, I wasn't so good with checking the comments. It was too exciting. Appreciate it, though. Let's see. Where was I? Oh, yes, cooking. Cooking stuff. Mobile vehicle bay. Ingredients unknown. We probably picked up the... We'll probably need to find the blueprints for that. That looks useful. Cook some boomerang. And more boomerang. Alright. We're good for food, we're good for water. Let's get going. Any which way but the Aurora. You know what, we set out straight for that pod that last time. That is pretty. Let's go parallel to the wreck. Or rather, parallel and to the right. Parallel and slanted off to that direction. There's no north, south, east, and west here yet. See how far we can go. And what we can find. I know there are... Oh, there are those whales again. I don't want to get too close to them. At least not during the dark. When I can't see what's going on. That is a pretty planet. With some weird, weird stuff going on down there. Like there's some clouds in the way or something. Or maybe the game is just loading wrong. Interesting soundtrack. Which apparently happens when you look up at the heavens for too long. I'll take it. It's pretty. Hope sunrise happens soon. Ocean at night? Spooky. Oh, those are the whales. Looks like they're coming this way. I am going to avoid them. Please don't hurt me. Alright, I think they're gone. Does that sound like waves breaking on a shore? That sounds like waves breaking on a beach. To me. Maybe it's just the Aurora. Ah, it's a pretty sunrise. Maybe now we can finally see what's going on down there. I think we're in some pretty deep water here. Go find out. There's a random cargo container. Propulsion cannon fragment. That's a good sign. Excellent. Well, that looks like it wants to bite me. Maybe just my imagination. Not too keen on finding out, though. Whoa, there's one. Nope. have any sort of gun on me. Alright, this, ridge? Oh, they once floated on the surface. Right, because that's how underwater rocks work. You know what? I think we can steer clear of those guys. Let's follow this, ridge. See where it takes us. Maybe there'll be more of those, cannons to scavenge. Unfortunately, they seem to pop into existence, not far ahead of me. Which is inconvenient. Inventory full? Come on! Alright, let's see if we can unload some stuff. We don't need all this quartz. Quartz are a dime a dozen. And we can drink some of the water. That'll help clear things up. Is that a diamond? No. That's okay, we can use salt deposits. Ah, leave me alone. I said leave me alone, dang it! Can I scan you from this distance? Bone shark. Somebody must have been here before. All these creatures have names. Inventory full. Ooh, something glowy down there. Let's go grab some oxygen and find out. Hopefully it's not another volcanic vent. Ice stalk. Looks like I didn't fully recharge my oxygen when I was up there. Let's go do that properly this time. Oh, power is at 5%. Alright. Let's recharge the battery first. R. There we go. Okay. Now, let's get down there. See what we can see.
It is your primary.
Oh, no, 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 no! Ah, it's a psychic thing! Ha ha ha, that's cool, mechanic, though. Noted! If I see one, I won't get any closer! I kind of want to go back down there. Is it gone? I don't see anymore. I hear something. Alright. Let's pick up a couple of these, because they're delicious. And more importantly, give off a lot of water when cooked, or when distilled. Get back here! Where on earth I'm going to find all of these things which I need in order to make a radiation suit so that I'm not stuck traveling away from the Aurora. Ah! Nope. Running away. Whoa! That looks cool. Inventory full. Okay, fine. I'll jettison some stuff. Drink some water and I'll eat. I'll eat my precious cured peeper. Still suit fragment. Excellent. Looks like it also looks like it's not loading properly, but also, as long as I can scan it, I'll take it. Can I open it? Cut open to access. Oh wait, I can't. I don't have a laser cutter. Noted though. What is that? That little thing. Leader. Oh! That sounds bad. I am not going to mess with it. Some more stalkers. That looks useful. Battery charger fragment. Man, there's all kinds of useful fragments around here. Ah! Alright. That must be the bleeder. Hey. I'm getting out of here. Relax. I'm leaving your precious habitat. It's not coming after me. Man, there's a lot of good fragments down there, though. And I've got a random first aid kit just sitting around. Let's go see if we can find a couple more. If they, in fact, exist down here. Mobile vehicle bay fragment. Excellent. This is all good news. It's trying to get at me, but stuck. That's a little sad. More of that sandy area. More salt. Salt's good. Oh, relax. It's unfortunately that the bleeders like to hang out in the kelp forests. I don't like those. I like those even less than the stalkers. I wonder what they adapted to feed off of, because it seems like feeding off of the stalkers might not be a good long-term strategy. I mean, parasites are pretty common in the real world, I guess. Ooh, a hoopfish. There are, they're parasites which hang off of whales in massive numbers. Is that one of those things you're not supposed to look at? That's one of those things you can't look at. Or it'll get you. Let's not look at it. Alright, inventory's full. We've scanned a few things. I'm not really seeing anything else around here we can easily scan. Maybe head back to the pod. Maybe not pausing to review the inventory right in the middle of the stalker forest. Although with the sea glider, it's a lot easier to... Oh! That looks promising. It's a lot easier to escape the stalkers than it used to be. Oh, there's a cave. We know we don't want to go in there because we had an unfortunate and embarrassing incident in there last time. That looks like another door we could, in theory, cut open if we had, If we had a laser cutter, which we don't because we don't have any diamond. Oh, there we go. That looks like that's another sea glide fragment. Let's keep heading back to the pod. Telling you guys about sperm whale communication, and then I got completely distracted by this beautiful game. So the sperm whales are able to make clicks and whistles, mostly clicks, and honestly more creaking than whistling, by forcing air that they've already breathed in while at surface through a valve inside their skull called monkey lips. This looks like we've got another communications. This is what interrupted my sperm whale rant last time. What the heck? I promise I'll get back to it this time. That didn't the caption didn't look so good. Subject destroyed. Well, we've got a new med kit. Except we can't use it. Let's make some filtered water here, because that stuff's always good to have. Cook us a hoopfish. Looks like a flounder. And a hoverfish. And then let's eat some of them. Cured hoopfish. This fish actually tastes like fish! Ironically, I wouldn't be surprised. People eat flounder a lot in real life, and if you were going to be a space traveler and you were going to come up with some kind of a fish substitute or something that tasted like fish, I'd imagine that that would be a good, sort of a good fishy, a standard fish taste that you would want to add to whatever nutritional supplements that you wanted to taste quintessentially like fish. Let's see. What can we swap out? You know, we've got some, not a lot of metal salvage. Let's go dump some of this. I think the metal salvage probably isn't gonna go anywhere. All that stuff we just dumped there isn't going there either. I mean, the stalkers might take it, but I just dropped an O2 tank. I will go pick that up, because that was silly. Also, our batteries with depleted charge. Don't need those anymore. I think I just dropped an O2 tank. If I just dropped an O2 tank, that would be... And it vanished? That would be bad. They're just gonna hang there? Oh, they're slowly sinking. There's the O2 tank. Metal salvage. You can go. Do any of these still have a space in them? Not really. These things, like, I'm not gonna put in a locker. I can find more of them pretty easily. The sun is setting. Gee, thanks, I didn't notice. Where am I going to find diamonds? And synthetic fibers, still. Still have no idea where to find those. We found some pretty cool habitats thus far. You know, let's try setting out in the direction of... straight out. That star doesn't really move. Let's go that away. Do some stellar navigation here. Stay up near the surface. Not a lot going on up here. In fact, you know what's weird? cars don't really move. Creepy. They really should. Or rather, it's not so much the stars should be moving, it's just that the stars should appear to whoa, what is that? That looked like one of those whale things. Glitching in and out of existence. I hope those aren't dangerous. I kinda don't want to go underwater and find out. Let's just sit here a moment. So I can talk about why the stars really should be moving. If the stars aren't moving, that means that the planet itself is not rotating. Which is a problem, because the sun rises and sets, which indicates that the planet is rotating, the side of the planet that we're on keeps rotating to face the sun and then away from it again. So why aren't the stars moving? This is a problematic, planetary conundrum of sorts. Alright, well, we're waiting for the sun to come up, I guess I can tell you about, and the whales to go away. I guess I can tell you about, sperm whale communication. Yeah, basically, they force air through a valve inside of their skull, and they do it so fast and so hard that it basically sounds like clicks. And, these clicks then, reverberate through this giant, sack of oil on the front of their heads. This used to be known as spermaceti oil, still is, and that is what they were hunted for back in the day. It was used as lamp oil because it burned without smoke. It was what lit the theaters of London and the houses of rural England for those who could afford it, because it was ridiculously expensive compared to other forms of lighting. I like how you've got the fish sort of tailing the whale. That's pretty cool. Just like real fish tail follow around larger creatures for various reasons. Either because they provide protection or... You're just floating on the surface, aren't you? There's a whole pod of them. I don't think they want to eat me. If I just hang back, I'll be okay. It's a little hard to see what's going on down there. You know what? Let's find out. We don't have to wait for the sun. Ooh. Glowy things. They look like lilacs. Redwort. Just sit here and scan that. And Violet Bow? Whales are nice guys, go hug them. I hope you're not trolling. You know what? What have we got? What do we have in our inventory, really? Fauna. Are the whales in here? And are they listed as carnivores or herbivores? Well, they're not in here. Perhaps they're not fauna at all. Perhaps they're flora. Well, we haven't scanned them yet. Subnautica whales are nice guys. Yeah. Alright, let's check what we have in our inventory. Are we gonna lose anything bad if we go hug them? And they kill us. Nothing bad we can't replace. Let's go do it. Sure are majestic, I'll give them that. You know what these remind me of? They remind me of an old TV series I saw a long time ago, which speculated what life on Earth might be like if it kept evolving over millions of years. Oh, they've got grass growing on top of them, even better. Greek barnacle. Well, it hasn't killed me yet. Let's go see if we can pick some of these barnacles off the top of them. It seems to indicate that I can. Oh, break barnacle, not break barnacle. It's indicating that I broke them. What just happened? I think it doesn't like me. Something doesn't like me. Well, something hurt me. Maybe the whale forced me out, bumped me? Maybe it was something on it. I think it's much more likely something on its back that I'm not supposed to touch. Ooh, silver-based computer silver ore! You can get silver off the backs of these whales? I think it's likely that thing touched me, honestly. Well, just like in real life, I suppose. Whales are important sources of resources. That's a little depressing, but it's true. Yeah, back in the day when we hunted whales, we used them for all kinds of things. From, regress shell. From, oil to light our homes to, Oh, okay, something hurt. Those things. I think the, Christmas tree worm-looking things. These guys. I think that's what's hurting me. I did see something go into the grass there, though. I think that was somebody... another whale's tendril. Coral shell plate. I hope it's happy I'm breaking barnacles off of its, shell. Some whales actually, There are whales in real life which grow barnacles on them, and moreover, there are whales which actually grow, I guess the closest analogy would be calluses on their shell, on their snouts. And, hello whale, what are you doing up in the surface? And these are unique enough to each whale that scientists can use the patterns of the calluses, which are technically called callosities, to identify the whales from a distance. Let's see. Are there any more barnacles I can break off of you? Well, not furled papyrus. Okay, what hurt me? I guess furled papyrus it hurts you too. All kinds of sea life that can hurt you on top of these guys. But the whales themselves don't seem harmful. It's so quiet up here. I think the sound just didn't load. It's got its tendril waving up in the air. Scan whale. Alright, I will scan the whale. Reefback. Well, I mean, that's a good name for it. Stay put! I want to scan you! You know what? Let's go ahead and read the encyclopedia entry about these guys. I want to see what the lore is for these things. Fauna! Reefback. Chitinous plating? Unidentified pods, green in color? Similar to the gastropod's algae gland tentacles. Assessment. Additional data required. I mean, my assessment is they're pretty cool. Will it help if I scan another one? Since we're here, and the whales seem friendly enough, let's go ahead and use the first aid kit, because we're a little low on health from running into all that stuff on their backs, and get some water, too, while we're at it. And then let's go down and see what's on the bottom around here. Maybe there'll be diamonds. Or synthetic fibers, or fragments of something we can use. Or just some delicious fish. What is that? Get back here. You're new. I want to pick you up. Reginald. Okay. Odd name for a fish, but... like it's shooting out things. I'm not going to get too close to it. That looks like another piece of a wreck. Maybe there's something to scan in here? Maybe? That'd be super cool. Or maybe there's those things, which are not cool. Why are you coming after me?
No.
Yes, ouch. Also you. I don't like you. And you don't like me either. Let's get out of here. Also, we're getting a little low on oxygen. On that piece of wreckage just yet, though. There's gotta be something around there I can scan. Oh, there's some sea fans! We have those on Earth! Let's see here. Veined nettle. Again, I'm willing to bet that if we had a laser cutter, we could get in there. Oh, we can just plain old get in there. Oh, cool. Looks a little glitchy, but...
30 seconds.
All right. Let's go up. And then we'll come back down and deal with the inside of this thing. There's gotta be something cool hiding in there. Hello, Will. Since we're exploring this, I figure I may as well, and there's, not anything particularly exciting at the moment. There's a couple of pieces of science news that from this week that I did want to share with everybody. One particularly exciting, piece of news, this is actually from last week, don't tell anybody. There was a frog, discovered in, Zimbabwe, which had been thought to be extinct. What was that? Oh, that was one of those things. What hurt me? Oh, one of you guys. You suck. There was a frog. A sea moth fragment. They've been thought to be extinct. Like I said, it's called the cave squeaker. It's a tiny frog, could fit in the palm of your hand. Oh, this is full of loot. And scientists have believed it to be extinct since 1962, I believe. Excellent. Man, this is full of stuff. Ah. So much cool stuff. Also a spadefish. So yeah,
30 seconds.
Let's not die down here. So yeah, just recently scientists found three males and one female of the cave squeaker frog in this cave after, let's head back to our pod and see if we can, see what these blueprints require exactly. Bye, Wills! I like you. I don't know if I love you, but I like you. No, I love you. You're cool. So scientists are hoping that either they can figure out how to breed them in captivity or that they'll find more. I don't believe they took these frogs into captivity. I believe they either left them out in the wild or collected them as specimens. But, long story short, this frog's not extinct yet. And that's pretty darn cool. I always like it when a frog when any animal really turns out not to be extinct after all. It's a... Even if it was an animal I didn't know existed, like the cave squeaker frog. It's always a good day when that happens. Still hope for that particular species. And, of course, there's a new message. Let's see what it is.
Broadcasting to all survivors of the Aurora. We've covered more than half the distance, so hold on in there. We're scanning the planet for dry land as we speak. You couldn't have picked a less convenient parking spot. but we'll be in touch as soon as we have a landing site for you. Sunbeam out.
Quite the contrary. If the ship had crash landed on land, then it probably would have shattered into a bazillion fragments. As it is, the water probably cushioned it, or at least helped put out the fires. That implies that there is dry land out there somewhere, too. I mean, it's not entirely implausible. It's right up near the surface. Cooked Reginald, pungent and smoky. Let's cook it. We're hungry. Also, because I did promise it in the video description, there is some happy news in medical clinical trials out this week. Now, I don't tend to cover medical stuff for a variety of reasons. First, because the vast majority of clinical trials are incremental, like, you know, it's like a tiny step towards progress of making some kind of cure, and I don't like to get overly excited about these sorts of things in advance. How come I have all these salt deposits? How come I couldn't cook the fish? Cure the fish. Alright, because I cooked the fish. Oh well. But there is a particular set of medical trials that I've been happy about for some time and following for some time. And I'm quite happy to see make some progress. It is designed to be an alternative to vasectomies. And I will tell you more about that as soon as I've looked at some of these blueprints here. We have... Actually, that would probably not be something you could use a fabricator for. Blueprints! So, we are one fragment away from the mobile vehicle bay, we are two fragments away from a sea moth, one fragment away from a stillsuit, and one fragment away from a propulsion cannon. Air bladder. Man, we know how to make so many things. Well, I think we had such great luck with that last wreck. I think that might be a good thing to do. Go out and, don't eat the rotten cooked hummerfish. Actually, don't eat anything, because you're in pretty good shape. Let's go out and find another wreck. What direction have we not gone yet? We haven't gone towards the Aurora, but I'd really rather not do that at all. What is that moving? It's probably a manatee. You know, that direction really had a lot of radioactivity going on, but we haven't gone just to the left of that other pod. Let's strike out that general direction. Actually, you know what? Let's scan the manatees. I'm not getting too close to that yellow goop, because that kills you. Yeah, you know, that's getting a little too close to the business end of that manatee for me, so, that shall remain unscanned, I think. Also, it's getting dark. Also, this thing is apparently out of batteries. Ah! Nope! Manatee pooped on me. Dang it. Alright, fine. Let's go back in here. See if we need any more health. We don't. That was temporary. We only have two more batteries for this thing. You know what? Let's make some more batteries before we head out. I know I have more copper ore lying around here somewhere. Let's just drop that. We are horrible polluters. Also, drop that rotten spade fish and the boomerang fish. Cook, drop all that cooked fish. We don't need it. Come here, peeper. I'm gonna eat you. Or cook you. I'm gonna cure you, is what I'm gonna do. away from those bursting clouds of nonsense and the manatees. Alright, so while I'm cooking this, I can go ahead and tell you about that new medical advance. It's meant to, like I said, it's meant to be a substitute for vasectomies. It's called Vasal Gel, or at least the that's the brand name that they're probably going to run with for it. A recent trial in rhesus monkeys has been successful in preventing pregnancy among the monkeys. Basically, it's a I'm going to get a little graphic here, so I'm sorry about that, but it's really cool. In a vasectomy, what usually happens is the tubes which take sperm from the testicles up through the reproductive system are cut so that the sperm doesn't actually get ejaculated. But that's kind of permanent. You can reverse it, but it's hard to reverse. And moreover, sometimes it accidentally self-reverses. Like sometimes. The body can actually heal that, and then suddenly you're not infertile anymore, and that's really awkward if you don't want to have any more kids. So what this stuff is designed to do is it's basically a spermicidal plug which is injected into the vas deferens, which basically instead of cutting the vas deferens, it stops the sperm from getting up from the testicles up through the rest of the reproductive system. In addition to being just a plug, it's supposed to have this cool electrical effect where the I think the positive charge of the gel interacts with the negative charge of the sperm, or vice versa. I can't remember. I feel bad that I can't remember. I didn't write this down. To essentially disintegrate the sperm as they approach the gel. So this has been in the works for several years now. There have been something similar, I believe, tested out in India, but the successful trial in the rhesus monkeys means that they're one step closer to getting it into human trials, which for me is super exciting. There's a lot of birth control options out there for women right now, like FDA approved, but not so many for men, and that makes me sad, because I am all about making sure that people have the medical treatment that they want and need. Alright, enough blabbering about alternatives to vasectomies. There's another medical fabricator there. How are we for everything? Pretty good. Did I cook that? I cured it? Yes, I cured that stuff. We've only got the one water, but what the heck. We're fine. I only need water. We'll pick up some more bladderfish when we're out. So yeah, I wanted to go this general direction. Hopefully we won't run into anything too radioactive. Oh, I wanted to make more batteries for this thing, too. Well, I've got one more. We'll go out until this one dies, and then we'll come back on the recharge. Hello, kelp. That sounds like another whale. I hope it's another whale and not something else. Let's wait here till the sun rises. This seems like a good place for Rex to me. But I can't see them because it's too dark. Or maybe I can't see them just because there aren't any. Let's go down a little bit. Well, it's not a new biome, actually. It's the blood red weed. Not weed as in, like, pot weed, but blood red weed as in, like in the War of the Worlds. That's what I'm thinking of. Ah, and there is a whale. There's a cave down there. You know how in the War of the Worlds there was this red weed, which the Martians accidentally or on purpose brought along with them from Mars. whale! Ah, nope, there's one of those dart things. Ah, ouch! Can I get close enough to break any barnacles on you? What is that noise? That's an unusual noise. I don't like it. Is that a whale noise? Didn't sound like a whale noise. However, I think I see a wreck over there. Let's go get some air and then come down and do the wreck. We don't need any silver right now. That's something we can worry about later. Yeah, there we go. Is this the same wreck we saw before? I couldn't get into. I gave up on. It's not good to get too much into the weeds here. Yeah, I think this is the same wreck I gave up on before. What is that? Oh, that's a sea moth fragment. I just didn't have my scanner equipped. I'll do it. Ah, yes. That is good news. Hello, whales. You're cool. That looks like another fragment of something. Hopefully these... Yeah, nope. I don't want you. That's another sea moth fragment. We're almost there. Yes! Blueprint unlocked for sea moth. That is cool. What's this rock over here? Can I scan that? Actually, no, you know what? Let's head on up, shall we? Get some more air. Much better. Man, there's all kinds of stuff on the backs of this whale. What is it offering me the option to do? I don't want to get too close enough to be hurt. I just want to get close enough to break the barnacles on your back. Look at those schools of fish. Too bad you can't actually use them. To get more silver. Why won't you let me? I think the game is starting to break on me a little bit. All right, let's go down. Let's go get more and more round of oxygen and see if we can't find any more fragments down there, down at the bottom. And you know what? While we're at it, I'm gonna grab some water, because we're up here anyway. I'm starting to get a little teensy bit dehydrated. That looks like a fragment of something, too. That sounds bad. What is that? It's a creature egg. Man, there's all kinds of creature eggs down here. You can't scan them, so who knows what they are. Once I have a laser cutter, hint hint, need some diamonds, hint hint, then I'll come back and cut open this door. Actually, you know what? We could wrench open that door on the other one. See if we can't do it here. No, we just started to glitch through it a bit. They're 106 meters down. That's pretty deep. I've never been that deep in real life. Well, actually, no, that's not true. I did go on a submarine ride once in Hawaii when I was on vacation there. but open to access. Nah, I haven't found any diamonds yet. So I can't make that.
30 seconds.
Alright, fine. What's that? A creature egg. Let's get up here so we don't drown, because that would be bad.
Oxygen.
I know. Are you a baby reef back? You don't have anything on your back. Or do you just not load yet? Oh, it's a little baby reef back. It doesn't have its whole community on its back yet. See, that's a mama reef back, or a daddy reef back, or a sexless parent reef back, depending. It's so cute. I wonder how you reproduce. It's like a cross between a portobello mushroom and a squid. It kind of reminds me of something out of Star Trek. Star Trek had a lot of space-borne aliens which looked kind of like this. Of course, this is, you know, ocean-going, not space-borne. Which is totally appropriate. Where on earth am I going to find diamonds? Hate to keep harping on that, but there's a lot of stuff we could get if we could just find that. Alright, one more time down here to see if there's anything we can scan. It's a little disconcerting how the edges of it are still glowing, like they're hot. Yeah, I think that's one of those things we're just not going to be able to access yet. Let's get up some more for some more oxygen. Oh, and I do have some, this actually reminds me. I have some kind of sad ocean-related news for you. Well, not really ocean-related. More just generic water-related, I guess. But you know what? Let's run with that. That wasn't a very good transition, but you gotta work with what you're given. The oldest fish in captivity died this week. Somebody's cooking something nice in my apartment building. You can smell it from a fair ways away. The fish in question was called Granddad. He was an Australian lungfish, and he was at least 90 years old when he died. We don't know exactly how old he was when he was captured, but we do know that he's been there since 1933. He was there during the World's Fair. What are you doing? That looks like stalking behavior to me. He's been kept at the Shedd Aquarium since he was brought there initially, and has been a beloved fixture there. His keepers said that he spent the vast majority of his 90 years pretending to be a log, because that is what lungfish do. Lungfish are actually pretty cool creatures. They are one of the few fish. Looks like it's getting dark out here, and it's hard to explore in the dark. So I think I'm gonna head back, make some more batteries. See what I can do with the stuff that I have already. What are those? Oh, that's what those are. Those are some of those floater things. I need to pick up some bladderfish, because I am almost out of water. Ah! And not get bitten by those things. That'd be nice. Oh, here's that pod I discovered earlier. Or is this a different one? Is this the same one? Yeah, this is the same one. Okay, now that wreckage is loading correctly. Yeah, since we're here and it's loaded this time, let's actually go and get some. Sun still hasn't set yet. But yeah, lungfish are one of the few fish that can actually, breathe air. Of sort. They have one lung. That looks Looks like a hatch, maybe? That's a stillsuit fragment. That's good news. That's another stillsuit fragment that's even more good news. That's another stillsuit fragment. And they're making it real easy to make a stillsuit now. I don't need any more of these, but what the heck. And that's a hole. This is quite clearly the stillsuit fragment ship. Or scavenge location, I suppose you could say. Get some more air. Let's see if there's anything else down here that we've missed now that it's loaded. If you came in there, you could get the stillsuit fragments. It's getting dark. Ooh, the wreck is glowing. And the light's pretty. I saw something you could scan. Oh, that's a limestone chunk. Inventory full. That looks like copper ore. Pretty much it for this wreck. I could be wrong. But you know what? Let's go see what it takes to make a stillsuit. That'll keep us out for much longer and we'll spend much less time trying to hunt down any unfortunate bladderfish. Which, by the way, I should probably pick some up of. Because we're all out of distilled water. Probably got an inventory full of titanium. Unidentified creature eggs all over the place. Let's eat some peepers. That'll help clear up some space. That looks like a fragment we can scan. Is it just metal salvage? Structural analysis. Scattered wreckage. That's real helpful. Looks like a fragment of something. That's another sea glide fragment. I'm a completionist. There's a bladderfish. Inventory full! What is this nonsense? Get rid of all this titanium. I don't need it. I do need you. Until I can make my stillsuit. What the heck? Let's pick up another salt deposit so we can cure some bladderfish or some fish of some description. There's a bladderfish. Come here. I need water. Stop dancing around. I need water. Thank you. Any bladderfish down here? Or just stalkers? Because I know stalkers live around here, and sometimes bladderfish, but I really only need the latter. Like I said, I really only need the latter. Stalkers, you can go away. Thanks, bladderfish. Hey! Inventory full again. What? What else can I jettison? I can pick up more acid mushrooms later. There are millions of them. Cruise up here. Right up in there. No new messages? That's unusual. Equipment! What is it? Fiber mesh times two! I don't have any fiber mesh! I can't freaking make any fiber mesh. Do I need like a blueprint to make fiber mesh? This is getting annoying. We're probably gonna drink like half of this in one go. Let's cure a boomerang. Because why not? Use up some resources and make some food for the road. That's better. That's more like it. Alright, that battery's dead. Let's make some more batteries. Do we have any more copper ore? Okay, so we have some copper ore just sitting there in our inventory. Maybe we shouldn't have dropped those acid mushrooms. Let's go pick some up. We don't need to worry. They're a dime a dozen. They're right here. Literally right under our house. Make some batteries. Alright, we're in pretty good shape. There we go. Let's charge up these batteries again once we get that finish that blueprint we started picking up some of. But that might take a while, so alright. You know what there's one direction I've been steadfastly avoiding because radiation poisoning. And that is towards the Aurora. But there's doubtless good stuff to be found in there. So today I think for our final day that I'm going to be playing in Subnautica today, we should make our way towards the front end of the Aurora and see how far we get. Maybe there'll be some more salvage there. Maybe we'll die of radiation poisoning. Who knows? Nothing in that cargo box. That's a door. Well, there's another wreck. And more manatees. Oh, that wreckage is still hot. That's not good. Oh, the sun's coming up. That's a good thing. Oh! Actually, that reminds me. I promise it does remind me and that this isn't just a random tangent. There really is a connection between these two things in my mind. The catfish that I told you about. I was looking up some catfish facts. Trying to find out more about this oldest about Granddad, the oldest one that died just recently. Turns out that there is a different species of lungfish called the marbled lungfish, which has the largest genome of any vertebrate. It comes out to 133 million base pairs. Which is pretty big. I forgot to write down how big ours is exactly, but certainly not that big. Go exploring in here. This looks like the same biome we're used to, but what do I know? Yeah, it is. There's a whole fish. Should have scanned it instead. down here. That's better. I better get out here before we anchor a crash fish. That'd be bad. Oh, there's another kelp forest over here. Let's go get some oxygen before we run out. Been down here a while. Finished battery charger, but you don't have base to put charger in, and you need mobile bay, vehicle bay to build Seamoth. That makes sense. I gathered the Seamoth was some kind of exploratory vehicle. So I guess I just need to keep finding blueprints. And hopefully we'll get enough to build something sometime. I wave my fish at you. Oh, that's another thing. I wanted to take a look at this. Oh, there's a there's that volcanic vent. Didn't we find that earlier, or is that a new one? I should really build some beacons so that I know. There you go, Gary Fish. That is just a... Oh! That is scannable. That's another sea glide fragment. I have that. I feel like a spoiled kid on Christmas. I already have that. Tell me about the creep vine. I'm gonna go all biologist on this. That looks like a piece of... something. Ooh. Shuttlebug.
30 seconds.
Alright. No shuttlebug is worth this. Let's get out of here. Ah! That eclipse again. Of metal salvage around here, but not an actual wreck, I don't think. Yeah, the whole fish. I was thinking about that, and I was trying to think of it, if there are any examples of life on Earth where there's a hole straight through it that you can... There's a trash can. Scan the trash can, please. Pretend you're in Bioshock. And you're scavenging it for goodies. Oh! That was actually a blueprint! Now I can build a trash can! This'll be useful for storing all my rotten Gary fish in. After I, after they go bad because I don't eat them. Come here, bladder fish. Oh, manatees, hello. Please don't kill me. I don't want to mess with you. How are we in relation to the Aurora? Oh, it's right there. Well, if we start getting radiation sickness, we'll go back. So far, things are going pretty well, though. Hold these things. That didn't sound good. Ah! Hey! What's eating me? Oh, one of you. How did I get you off of me? And can I please use my health? Apparently not. Apparently my first aid kits are inaccessible while there's a bleeder on me. You died and lost some stuff. Probably most of my cured fish. Well, no, actually. Surprise. Didn't lose very much at all. Still, let's go ahead and eat some of that fish. Still, that seems like a good direction to journey in generally. Let's do that again. There's some good stuff out there. the stuff for scanning. Stay out of those tall kelp fronds. That's where the bleeders apparently live. Oh, radiation detected. Let's back up a bit. That stuff saps your health pretty quick. Alright, so it looks like those pillars are kind of the limit of where we can go. Where it starts to slope off. That's where it gets a little bit too much for us. We can run parallel to it, though. That should not be a problem. Is there something in there? Nope. Maybe there's something under here? More metal salvage. We'll probably have to jettison that because we don't need more titanium. Well, the music just cut off rather abruptly. It's not ominous at all. There's another manatee. More salvage just floating around. Ah, here's another drop off. That's a good sign, means we're getting out there into the ocean. Maybe there'll be another biome out this way. Oh, radiation detected. We're nowhere near the aurora. Okay, yeah, I guess we kind of are. Moreover, we're on the end with the engines. So, I could see why radiation would be coming out of that end, frankly. Ah, more of these sandy flats. And there's radiation detected out here! Nonsense. There's whales out there. I hope they're not getting irradiated. I like them. Who knows? Maybe life on this planet doesn't use DNA, which means that the DNA can't then be degraded by radiation, which means that they're immune to radiation sickness. That'd be cool. Probably doesn't work like that, but it'd be cool if it did. Oh, what's this? That is a deep hole. I am very tempted to go down it. Yeah, let's do it. No time like the present. Actually, thinking about the seabed reminds me. Ah, there's a whale. Hello, whale. There was a news story out this week about one of the earliest sea slugs has been discovered. Or rather, not one of the earliest sea slugs. The earliest known mollusk has been discovered. So mollusks are a class of creatures, which today include things like, we don't want to touch a lot of these things. These things are toxic. Please don't mess with me. Coral shell plate, that's cool. Writhing weed. Ooh, what's that? Can I touch it? Rouge cradle. If I go this way, am I gonna regret it? How's my oxygen? Let's turn back around and get out of here. Before we run out of oxygen. Woo! Hey, whale. So yeah, mollusks are a class of creatures which today include everything from, like, squids and octopi through to snails and slugs. I'm like 90% sure that those are mollusks. How embarrassing. I'm so distracted by this hole. Looks like there's another exit here. Maybe? Nope, this just leads out here. Ah! And there's another one of those things. They hurt. But this earliest known mollusk that was found in Morocco, it was a fossil. It was found was 480 million years old, which I think is pretty cool. I mean, we talked about some earliest deuterosomes last week, which are way older than that, of course. But, you know, 480 million years, not too shabby. It apparently looked exactly, you would describe it today, as a spiny slug. You know, it had a sort of a gnawing mouth on one end and some spines coming out of the top and a big old foot on the bottom. And it lived at the bottom of the ocean. Or maybe some fresh water. I think ocean, though. Why? You keep shooting at me! What'd I do to you? Apparently, oh, you guys. Hello. Hello, is this thing on? Hi. My name is Bird. I am a dead, stuffed European starling. And I'm here because Elizabeth made a mistake. It's true. She does her research, but sometimes she gets some things wrong, and this is one of those times. It has to do with that mollusk she was just describing as she was trying to explore the hole. Turns out, it is not the earliest mollusk ever found! It's not even close to the earliest mollusk that we know of. And there are certainly mollusks that go back a lot longer than that. So, let's clear this up. What was the earliest mollusk? Well, it's a little hard to say because the earliest mollusks were soft and squishy. Not like me. I'm covered in beautiful feathers, which would fossilize rather easily. No, the earliest mollusks were made out of soft tissue, and the only things which fossilized were the outlines of those tissues and their teeth, which they had a lot of. However, we do have several sea slugs, which lived long before the spiny slug that she just mentioned. For example, there's Odontogryphus olimus. This was a soft, squishy slug, which lived up in British Columbia 560 million years ago. That's a good 80 million years earlier than that spiny slug. For comparison, it only took you featherless humans about 13 million years to diverge from the rest of the apes. So, moral of the story, Elizabeth didn't do her research. She got distracted by a hole. And also, mollusks are really frickin' old. And pretty cool. Now, back to Subnautica! Keep hoping that in one of these biomes I'll find some diamond. The stillsuit needs silver, though. And whales do have silver. Oh, they're mating? Somehow I wasn't envisioning it quite like that, but okay. Actually does kind of look like whales mating. I have some cool whale sex stories, which I probably won't tell because they're a little lewd. I've talked to a lot of whale biologists over the course of my years, and they got some stories. I don't want to touch that thing. That thing hurts. They probably just got stuck on top of one another. I should not disparage the whales. That's another wreck! Let's go down and get it before the sun sets. Way to get in? Can we open this door? Nope. Do the whales like to hang around the wrecks? That's what it seems like to me. Is there a way in? Yes, there is. Straight down. To scan it with a fish. That's a little useless. That looks like a data fragment. Transgov profile, Mongolian independent states. No signal. We got some cargo here. Mobile bay fragment? Yes! Yes! We can make it now. Propulsion cannon fragment. Yes. We're getting a little low on oxygen. Let's go up to the surface.
30 seconds.
Get some more oxygen in our brains. sun's starting to set. It's gonna be a little hard to explore this after dark. So let's get in here while we still can. And then I think after that, I may have to call it a night and head back to the pod and pick this up again next week. But this has been fun so far. I'm enjoying Subnautica. Mobile bay, vehicle fragment, desk. Let's scan the desk. Looks like this one contains pretty much everything you need to make the mobile bay. Floodlight! Let's scan a floodlight. Cool. There's another mobile bay fragment. I'm just gonna scan everything in here until nothing else comes up as scannable. Make sure I don't miss anything. I know I'm scanning way more of the mobile bay fragments than I need to, but... yeah, I think... chair! Let's scan the chair! Then we can make a chair! Now we have an... now we can...
30 seconds.
I know, I'm coming up. Hey, whales! Oh, also, there's one other piece of science news that I learned today, which is kind of fun. Yeah, let's head back and see what it's going to take to make this mobile bay. Oh, it says we can break the barnacles. I want to break it. I want to get the silver. Let me break your barnacles. Oh, I'm walking on it. There's a piece of ore, silver, just wandering off. Ah, I dropped it. Dang, I'll have to go find some more whales. Too hard to see in the dark. Yeah, so, there's a... whale sex stories. It's, yeah, I promise I have them. And I may tell them someday. But not right now. Oh, that's the volcanic vent, and I just swam right over it because I make good decisions. But yeah, there was a new science story out just today. Maybe yesterday? Oh. It looks like my sea moth ran out of charge. Or I was holding a fish. Yeah. Let's swap out the battery here. There we go. Get home in a jiffy. Yeah, turns out there's a species of crab called boxer crabs. And scientists have known for a long time that these crabs had a weird thing going with themselves and sea anemones. The crabs have special hooks on their claws, which seem specially designed to hold on to the bases of sea anemones. What was that? Oh, crash fish, probably. So they wander around, and each claw has a sea anemone on it. And these seem to serve a couple of different purposes. Sea anemones can sting, so they can use these anemones as a defensive function. They also seem to be able to use them to... let's make some water here, if we can. Good, because we're almost getting thirsty. They also seem to be able to make... to capture food in their little wavy tendrils, which the crab can then pick off and eat. So scientists knew they had these anemones on their claws, but they didn't know exactly where they were getting them or kind of what their deal was, really. We'll eat this one now. And drink some water. And we'll listen to the message, and I'll finish telling you about the crabs.
Aurora, it's Sunbeam. We've made orbit, and scans have found a landing site on the planet that's only rated hazardous.
Sunbeam will arrive in 40 minutes.
We've sent you the coordinates. We'll be there in 2 days' time. Cross your fingers, the weather holds. Don't leave us waiting. Sunbeam out.
Yes! Sunbeam will arrive in 40 minutes. All right. So, I desperately want to make it out to the landing site. So let's actually go, but now there's a timer. So, let's go back to the game and see exactly how far away this thing is. How far away is this landing site? There's the two escape pods. Woo! Well, you know what? Let's grab some batteries, make some batteries, and head out there. Inventory full. We can drop these creature eggs, honestly. Whoa, those are big. Silver ore. Oh, no, I wanted to drop the metal salvage, not the O2 tank. We need the O2 tank. There we go. Drop that. And copper ore. I know we have some more in these lockers somewhere. Unless we don't, in which case we may have to make some emergency choices here. Did we look at that one yet? That's titanium. All right. We gotta get some limestone breaking action here. Get some copper ore. Real quick, doesn't particularly matter from where. Gotta be some down here. I can't fit this whole area clean. Ah! Crash fish! Crash fish! Crash fish! Oh, silver ore. I mean, that's good. Another one of those holes. Copper ore. Wait, no, don't fall all the way. Thank you. I need you. Get up here so we don't drown, because that would be bad.
30 seconds.
It recharged on the oxygen. Oh, it's half a blast fish, a crash fish egg. Oh yeah, so the, I can talk about the, crabs. Why come down here and get some ore, hopefully. Whoa, look at this! This is so cool! Those are probably gonna kill me. Like, that looks like it's killing me. And we have a deadline to hit. But that is so cool down there. It reminds me of the, first of all, there's an eel, multiple eels, living inside those things, which is nifty and totally replicates things which happen in real life. Got a commensal relationship, or maybe just a parasitic one. I don't even know. It reminds me of the, stage of a jellyfish's life, which really does happen. When in at least some species, where they basically just sit on the seafloor and grow, and then they spawn off the what we know as a jellyfish, which then sort of comes up to the surface and floats or spends the next stage of its life floating around. There is a species of jellyfish called the quote, it's colloquially known as the immortal jellyfish, which can go back and forth between these stages for pretty much its whole life. Over and over, back and forth from, you know, juvenile up to, back up to, adults, floating around in the water like a regular, what we think of as a regular jellyfish stage, and then back to, and then when it needs to, it can go back to the, baby, sitting on the seafloor stage. Alright, let's make some food here. Well, we don't have any of that. But we can cook some Gary fish. And we can make some batteries. Advanced wiring kit needed for the propulsion. Fine! Fine. Titanium ingot lubricant power cell. We can take all of those except the power cell, I think. What does it take to make a power cell? Oh, there's a wiring kit. We need gold ore for the advanced wiring kit. But no, we're going to go meet that ship. 30 minutes. 30 minutes to go. Got two batteries. All we need is some bladderfish so we can have enough water for the trip. Let's go out and get those. Where are we going to find bladderfish? Probably out near the kelp, honestly. There's one. There's another one. That's two bottles of water. There's another. That's three bottles of water. I'd like one more. It's a biter. I don't want that. There's a bladderfish. That's four bottles of water. That's acceptable. I'll take that. Let's grab a peeper, if we can. And a garyfish. Basically any fish that stumbles across our path will be our dinner as we make our way to the new site. Pick up an extra first aid kit. Inventory full. Okay, fine. Let's make some filtered water. And we'll just make some more filtered water. Excuse me. Yeah, the crabs. The cool part about the study, which I keep starting and I haven't finished yet. The cool part about the study that they did was they looked at the genetics of the crabs, of the anemones that these crabs were carrying around on their claws. And what they found was that they, first of all, they belonged to several different lineages. So they knew they weren't they knew that they may probably be interacting with other anemones in the wild. It's not like there was this one species that lived on the crab claws and nowhere else. What they also found... Get all hydrated here. And get the health up to full. Let's get some more bottled water. We got 30 minutes till it arrives. That's still time. But in studying the crabs, what they found was that, the crabs were actually, first of all, small crabs, baby crabs, who didn't have any anemones yet, would fight with larger crabs and steal their anemones. I don't want to fight with you, Stalker. Go away. I just want your fish. I'm going to fight with you like crabs do for anemones. And there's some volcanic vents under here. Is there any more fish? Any more bladderfish I can grab? Yeah, there's some. There's a stalker. Don't care. Just want fish. Get some more boomerangs. So yeah, small crabs would fight with the big crabs for their, jettison some titanium, make some more room. Don't need these acid mushrooms. But also, once they had one anemone, I think this is the cool bit, they would hook the anemone onto their claws, and then they would start stretching it. They just stretch it right in half until it actually ripped in half. Now, for most animals, in case you didn't know, this would kill them. But not the anemone, because anemones have this nifty adaptation where if you split them in half, the two halves can each regenerate into their own anemone. This is actually one way in which they reproduce, naturally. I mean, they kind of pull themselves in half, and then each one transforms into a new anemone. But the crabs, they force the anemones to do this by ripping them in half. And this is great for them, because then they can basically have two anemones instead for the price, so to speak, of one. And you know what? I think we are good to go for our journey. Let's go. Let's go to the site. Go to the site and hang out. Where is the crash site? There we are. Alright. Glitch out, if you will. This is away from the Aurora, so, well, it's kind of parallel to it. So we're good. We're on our way. Avoid the manatees, please. Sound glitching in and out. Yeah, it is kind of metal, I know. Like, you wouldn't think that. They're not very big crabs. They just kind of crawl around on the ocean floor doing crabs, doing whatever crabs do, eating stuff. But nope, they rip invertebrates apart and wear them on their claws, like kind of the crab equivalent of brass knuckles. So that they can defend themselves with them. I think it's a kind of a nifty adaptation. And the thing is, it's unclear exactly how much this harms or hurts the anemone. It's pretty clear that the anemones do better if they're not hanging out on the crab's claws. What is that? That's an island! I couldn't see that from over here. And now it's gone. Nope, there it is! Wild! I knew I heard waves from over this general direction. Cool! Oh man! There's some cool stuff hanging out on this mountain. Magnetite! Oh man! Now I know where magnetite is. I wish I made a beacon so I could find out where this, so I could return to the site, because hate to say it, but that sunbeam is probably that rescue ship, I'm willing to bet. Uranite crystal? I'm black basalt outcrop. Anyway, detecting massive energy signature in the region. Cannot identify. Well, as long as it's not radioactive. This is cool. Well, the landing site isn't that far away. Maybe this is where the diamonds are. Inventory full. Can we eat something? Yeah, we're feeling a little bit thirsty. Let's pick up whatever that was. Gold! Haha! We'll be rich! Except that there's nothing to spend it on. Some large basalt rocks? Yep, this is a volcanic island of some sort. Is that diamonds? Please be diamonds. Please, oh please, oh please. Oh, that's magnetite. We can jettison the decomposing Gary fish. Diamonds! We have diamonds! Ha ha! And that looks like something scannable. Materials you gather are property of the Altera Corporation. Yeah, screw you, Altera. Sorry. You dumped me on this deserted island. Look! It's a crab! Crab-like thing? Oh, it hurts! Okay, fine. I will not mess with the crab. Not wild about being out here after dark. I don't want to be attacked by the crabs. Now we got food for days. We're fine. I wish I thought to bring along one of those... Oh, that's more magnetite. One of those titanium lockers. You bite. I don't like you. Ah! Case in point! What'd I do to you? I'll just, wait it out. Didn't take us that long to get over here. What is that? I'm gonna be saying that a lot this episode, I think. No more titanium. Don't need you. Diamonds, yes. All the diamonds. Lithium! Ah, excellent! Now if we, start to have some mental instabilities, we'll be fine! Lithium, in case you didn't know, is a, something you can take. What is that? Is that something I recognize? Oh, that's a Reginald. I am not gonna finish this episode until the sunbeam gets here. Although, like I said, I have a suspicion it's probably going to crash horribly. Bitey! Let me scan you. Well, with the diamonds, we can make the cutting tools that we require to get into even more wrecks. So that's good. I like these things, this sort of bioluminescent things. They remind me of, oh, what are those things? Some of the deep sea invertebrates that you see in the real world, which have sort of cilia around their edges, which look sort of iridescent when you shine regular light on them. I'm completely blanking on the name, and that's a bit shameful, honestly. Alright, we've regenerated some health. Let's see if we can't get on land a little bit. Yes, there are crabs on land which can kill us, but, what are you? But the biters can't get us! Ah! Take that, biter. Bulbo tree. It's like a baobab tree, but alien. Okay. Can't see what I'm doing. Whoa. What is that? I wish it were daytime so I could see what that is. That looks like some kind of, structure. Honestly? Like, that's not natural. Scan any of these things? I mean, yes, the sunbeam landing site is right there, but I don't want to approach that until the daytime, quite frankly. I want to see what I'm getting into. Go looking on the island. You have no idea. I'll wait till the sun comes up. I can't see anything. Ah, what the heck. Oh, that's one of the crabs. And it finished! Ah! Loading. Gotta let... I'm willing to bet that alien tower's gonna shoot the sunbeam right out of the sky. Don't you dare attack me. I'm busy. Huh? It looks like a path up here. Ooh. It lights up as you approach it. Okay. My scanner doesn't recognize it. We still got 20 minutes till Sunbeam shows up. Oh, wow. Purple artifact. Because it's always a good idea to scan random alien artifacts. Data downloads. Alien artifact. Alright, let's go ahead and check that tab. Data bank. Alien life forms. Alien artifact. Alien algae growth on the exterior of this device indicates it was abandoned hundreds of years ago. May be compatible with other alien technologies. Can I climb this thing? No. Is there anything else on this island? Well, there's the Aurora. Man, we walk slowly. Oh, there we go. They're sprinting. Let's climb up here before we go explore the alien structure itself. See if we can... That's a crab. Nope. 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 Ah! It's covered in these things! Oh, cool. Ah, no! I'm covered in them. Go away. Pink cap. Ah, stop it! I don't want to hurt you. Oh, salt deposits. I traversed... the cave crawler cave. They don't seem to be following me. I want to go further into the cave? Or up here? I want to keep going all the way to the top. Man, it's pretty. Interesting how... Okay, I swear I heard footsteps. Oh, stop it, cave crawler. Interesting how I couldn't see this giant island from over there. I mean, I know it's a little ways away, but it's not that far away. I'm glitching through the wall! Oh, ow. Okay, fine. Sure is pretty up here, though. Let's go into this little cave here. Still got 15 minutes till the... Alright, I take fall damage. Good to know. Man, so much lithium! If I ever need lithium, I'll know where to go. Man, this whole mountain is riddled with them. I'm gonna go try and explore that alien structure now. I can make my way out here. I'm sure there's more cool stuff in there, but I don't particularly feel like losing all my health to cave crawlers. Help, I suppose, if I didn't run right through them. But I gotta get out of this cave! This is the way it came. All this glitching in and out is starting to make me dizzy. Things just aren't loading right. I think I'm running in circles. That's embarrassing. I just want to get out to the Sunbeam landing site. Is that too much to ask? Apparently so. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and jump, get to the top here, and then jump out and take the fall damage. Because I'm getting sick of this. And I'll just swim around the edge. Yeah. Let's go ahead and get a first aid kit here. Geremo! Hey! Jumping into water doesn't deal fall damage. Oh, that doesn't look good. That's big. Let's swim right out of here. Alrighty. We ready to explore this alien artifact? Yeah. Our alien artifact structure? We might die. I don't know. I don't know if these aliens were friendly or not. Let's find out. Seems to be a way in up there. However, down by the beach, it's another story. That gate down there seems to be making some humming noises. Ah! Ow. Just falling off of rocks is what I'm good at. That looks like something I can scan. It's broken. Gave me some titanium. Artifact terminal. Let's check out that encyclopedia entry. The device appears to be alien in origin, is connected up to a nearby force field. Technology is far beyond anything encountered before by the Federation. Nonetheless, it appears to function like a normal lock. It only needs the correct kind of key. Gee, I wonder what we gotta look for now. Oh. Insert artifact. Do we actually have it in our inventory? No, we didn't. We just left it lying there. Let's go get it. I was just like, let's scan it and then leave it on the ground. Hidden very well, was it? Oh, get out of my face! Stop waving it in front of my eyes. Will we discover the secrets of the alien monument before the Sunbeam shows up? Yes. It's gonna trap us behind it. In here, isn't it? Metal alloy with unprecedented integrity. No matches found in database. Well, they have a good sense of interior design. thinking the other day that this felt like a young planet. You know, there wasn't a whole lot of biological diversity on it yet. But obviously intelligent life has shown up here before. Message reads. Warning, unidentifying craft in orbit of this planet will be destroyed. What was I saying about the sunbeam? We don't really have any way of communicating with them back either, do we? That communications array apparently only works one way. Can we turn this thing off? Data terminal.
Unknown language. Attempting translation.
Can we save the sunbeam? Let's see.
Integrating new PDA data.
Let's see. On first, the terminal began, let's see, matches no known technologies constructed for the same solid-state computer of some kind, no recognizable user interface. Mental processing power required to perform this kind of telepathy would require the designers, would imply the designers are considerably more psychologically developed than the common human. Further alien data required. Well, let's go run and grab some! Whoops. Actually, you know what? Let's save. Just in case. Okay. I suppose there's no real hope of saving the sunbeam, but we can sure try. Oh, it's probably functional. These things always turn out to be secretly functional. Control room in the lower section. How do you know there's a control room here? Ion crystal. Maybe spending all that time dithering about exploring the island wasn't the best idea. Picked up ion crystal. Go get all the ion crystals. Unknown language. Tempting translation. Great. Whoa! Ah! Oh dear. Okay. That's great. I hope I don't take fall damage from this. In The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, which, insert artifact! I only had the one! Dang it! A couple of ion crystals. Ah, let's go back up. Where are we gonna find another artifact in 5 minutes? We're probably not. Let's see. Let's check that alien terminal. Or alien schematic. Let's see. The facility was to be powered by a separate self-sustaining power plant located somewhere on the planet. Well, that's great. We gotta find that. Engineering section, where the schematic was found, in the control room. Which is... separate underwater moon pool? Alright, let's go find the moon pool! We have 5 minutes! Let's do this! Sun is setting. Grand. Can't see what I'm doing. Okay. Cool. It's probably going to be pretty deep. Oh, holy cow, there's a lot of this thing. Sure would be easier to see this in the daytime. The walls aren't lighting up when I shine my light on them. What was that? What the heck? Are you one of them? Are you one of the intelligent creatures that made this place? Or do you want to hurt me? Oh, nope, you want to hurt me. Like a lot. Ooh, well. You can teleport. That's good to know. This looks promising. Alright, let's go in here. No, apparently that's a wall. Gee, it sure is hard to see anything in the dark. What was that? Oh, that was another one of you. Hi. I need to go up for oxygen. Get further down. Let's see. Oh, there! That looks like it. I'm shocked I'm not having some radiation poisoning difficulties here. There, there's another ion crystal inventory full. Well, let's fix that. I apparently can't jettison things, so I'm just gonna eat them. Lights are coming on over here. That's a good sign. This looks like a control room of some description. It went dark. Went dark when I approached it. Guessing I don't have everything I need yet. And it's cut. The sunbeam is landing in 1 minute. We're not gonna make it. We are not gonna make it. There's an artifact. Don't miss the landing! Well, I can't. I'm stuck in this ship. Insert artifact. There we go. I'm trying to save the sunbeam! I can't be there for the crash if I can't save it.
Attention, patching in a local broadcast.
Disable facility! Turn it off!
I don't believe it. There's someone down there. Aurora survived. We have your PDA signature.
It took a DNA sample?
Let alone survive since then. We'll be happy to bring you on board and hightail back to Federation space. Stand back. We're approaching the landing
site.
Well,
it scanned me. I tried to turn it off.
4, 3.
I'll miss all the fun outside, I know.
The red spike.
Ah, I'm stuck down here. Oh. Well, it exploded. Sounds second facility somewhere on the planet, 800 meters below sea level. I tried to save you, I'm sorry. It wasn't enough. I guess I gotta go out the way I came in.
Mild dehydration detected. Fluid intake recommended. Vital signs stabilizing.
There we go. Well, I tried. Disease research facility. Apparently that's what this was. Well, I'll go outside and at least see the crash site.
Is broadcasting a message. Translation reads, warning, infected individuals may not disable the weapon. This planet is under quarantine.
Oh dear.
Scans of available alien data indicate the presence of a second facility elsewhere on the planet. Evidence suggests it is located 800 meters below sea level. Ooh. Approximately 1 kilometer southwest of
oh.
This installation.
Oh, that's bad. That's bad. Out of the way. Get out of the way.
Oh,
it's not collapsing. It was rotating. That's a cannon. Wasn't immediately obvious at first. Yeah, that must have shot that thing out of the sky. I'm gonna have to go find somebody else's, recording of that, because I am a little sad to miss that, honestly. The Sunbeam must have... It was scheduled to land. There is a console command. Yeah. Oh. That looks a bit glitchy. There we go. No, still a bit glitchy. Yeah, the Aurora was supposed to... The Sunbeam was supposed to land somewhere over here. Maybe it's, crashed down there. Or maybe not. Still got those... weird creatures appearing and disappearing. I don't know if those are the aliens, but I would say that's likely. Well, since rescue isn't happening, and it's getting kind of late here IRL, and I seem to have disappointed everybody with the... Ah, no! Get away from me! I don't want to hurt you. With missing the Aurora crash site. And now I'm getting attacked by crabs! Not the Aurora crash site. The Sunbeam crash site. I think I'm probably gonna call it a night. I'm gonna start heading back here so I can remember, where I was. But despite missing all the fun outside, we did get pretty far and we did try to disable the facility. Yeah, and because this thing is starting to get a... Yeah, I'm gonna see what happens if I restart the game. Not now. But hopefully next time I restart, we won't have quite so many things not loading properly. In any case, thank you so much for tuning in and joining me tonight. I'm going to be back streaming again on Thursday with Depth, I think. Tuesdays is going to be Subnautica, Thursdays is going to be Depth, and then Saturdays is going to be XCOM. So I hope you'll all join me again for that. Thanks so much for tuning in. Again, sorry to miss that crash. Must be cool. And hope to see you all again on Thursday. Thank you so much for, thanks for tuning in. And hope you all have a good night. Oh, Josh Goddoss? I guess that's how you say it? Thank you so much for that link. That is super helpful so everybody can see what I missed. I'm also, if that's okay with you, I will also go ahead and put that in the channel feed. So that, this video is probably going to go up on YouTube later this week. So, hopefully, I'll put it in the description there so everybody can see what I missed because I was too busy saving, trying to save the ship. All right, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in and, hope y'all have a good night.